With all of these changes this past week, we at Webster and Garino have been trying to analyze and to figure out how does this affect our clients, our individual clients and our business clients. And one of the things that is in the forefront, I think, of a lot of people's minds, and we're certainly thinking about it, is what happens when your business is being told it must shut down. So there's obviously a couple of sides to the story. On the one hand, we have small businesses and their employees who are worried about being able to come out the other side. And we have another concern in terms of, you know, doing all of our civic duty to try to do what we can to help keep things under control. So what we thought we would do today, we're having a conversation in our office, and we thought we would just present two sides of the story from kind of a legal perspective. This is a constitutional issue, and so we thought we would just share this with you.
Yeah, and give a little background on police powers. So in general, states have police powers. And what police powers are, they're laws and rules that the government has to protect the welfare, safety, and health of its citizens. And so the power is reserved by the state via the 10th Amendment. So there's a lot of discussion right now about what the federal government's going to do. But in actuality, a lot of the power still resides with the state and the governor. So that's why you're seeing the governor in the state of California, the governor in Illinois, and the governor's coming out with these travel restrictions or business closures. And so from the small business perspective, the argument is, if I'm a small business owner and I have to work to feed my family, can the government shut my business down without due process?
Well, and then the question is, what is due process? And right now, the government is trying to contain a health situation with the COVID-19 virus all across the country at this point in the globe. And so what is that due process and what does it look like for a small business? The government's certainly going to say, hey, we have a duty and a right to protect our citizens from this health crisis. But the question for the small business becomes, what's the cost? And Will can talk about what is the cost, right? What does that look like?
Yeah, so I think the government's argument is going to be, it goes something like this. So we need to stop the spread of the coronavirus. We have the authority to protect the health of our citizens. And in order to stop the spread, we're going to close businesses or try to limit social interaction. And so from the small business owner's perspective, it's, well, what do I do now? My business is closed. Do I have due process? What arguments can I make? And I think for a small business owner, I think there's some case law that could support an argument that the government cannot use its police powers in a way that unduly, again, that's a key word, unduly burdens commerce without due process. So again, I think it's an important thing to look at as a small business owner is, if my business, if I'm, you know, am I a gymnasium? Should a gymnasium be treated the same way as a small business? If I'm a one-pop shop, should I be treated the same as a business that maybe that has a lot of customers in it? If I've never had a COVID-19 coronavirus case in my building? And so these are, I think, all things a small business is thinking about, and whether the government can shut my business down without establishing that my business in some way harms the public interest and the public health.
And like Will said, it's going to use its police power to come in and say, yes, I can. And the reason that I can is because we are seeing that this virus is spreading very quickly. It's all over the news. Everybody can look and see that. And part of the reason why the government is doing what it's doing with respect to closing schools, restricting travel, and all of the other things that have been proclaimed across the country at this point is because we're trying to slow the spread of this disease and this virus. And so it's not a matter of, can I close an individual business? Right now it is, can I save the population of the country, and how are we going to go about doing that? And the difference is, and the argument is that the government, whether it's the state government like Will talked about, or whether it's the federal government, they're looking at the whole, right, the population as a whole, and how is that balanced and weighed between an individual business owner?
And for our small business owners, I think if these provisions or these restrictions stay in place for a significant amount of time, a lot of people are going to be put in tough places. Do I let employees go? Do I close my business? What do I do? Or who can I reach out to? Where can I get help? And so I think it's worth looking into. If you find yourself in that situation, feel free to give us a call. And whether the government can close your business without due process, you may be entitled to a hearing, and where the government has to come in and establish the nature of your business, how many employees you have, and does your business pose a risk or threat to the public safety?
And you know, clearly we're not going to come to any sort of a conclusion today. However, really this is about, you know, understanding our rights and kind of these evolving and changing times, and knowing there are people here who can help you with that.